Hey there, I'm Senki, and in this video I'll be taking a look at setting up your ship's thrusters and how to troubleshoot them. In the last video, I went over ship frames, and there I spoiled a little bit about thruster placement already, but this video will be much more in-depth, and I'll also go over setting up the ship's control devices, namely the main flight computer and flight control unit. Where on the ship you put your thrusters actually matters a lot in Starbase. You can't just put one thruster in every direction and expect your ship to fly well. The minimum practical thruster setup that's being used right now has 4 thrusters only. For most ships, you'll probably want a few more though. There's 4 different types of thrusters in the game currently, of which the smaller 3 all have 3 different tiers. I'll show the different stats for each thruster's tiers on screen as I go over them, though on triangle and box thrusters, you can also mix and match parts to get different results. In general, tier 1 parts are cheap, available with only materials that can be found within the safe zone. Tier 2 uses materials from outside the safe zone, but still within the belt, and is the most efficient of the 3. Tier 3 uses materials only available on moons, and has the highest thrust output of all tiers, but is less efficient than tier 2. Now, let's have a look at each type of thruster individually. Maneuver thrusters are weak and inefficient, but very small. They're usually only used to turn a ship, though some ships might use them for main propulsion. They only have a single part, so they don't require any assembly. They also have the least visible of all thruster trails, so some ships will use them to become harder to see. Triangle thrusters are a good middle ground, with decent thrust output for their mass and volume, and fairly average consumption. They are probably the most used main thruster right now, since they are very easy to place and don't take up much space. They also have a unique connection port on their sides that allows them to share propellant and power with adjacent triangle thrusters. This automatically groups them as well, so you'll only have to rename one in each block of thrusters, and they'll all fire at the same time. Triangle thrusters consist of 5 parts: the triangle thruster body, triangle thruster combustion chamber, of which there's only one tier, the triangle thruster nozzle, and then a fuel and gas converter. Box thrusters are another fairly average option, with lower propellant usage per unit of thrust, but much higher power usage than triangles. They are mostly useful for putting on the side of a ship, since they are fairly long and have their hardpoint connection on the side. I personally don't have much of a preference for either box or triangle thrusters, and it very much depends on the ship which one I'll use. Or, of course, you can use a mix of both. Box thrusters also use 5 parts: a box thruster body, box thruster combustion chamber, which again only has one tier, a box thruster nozzle, and then again a fuel and gas converter. Lastly, there's the plasma thruster. This one is kind of in a class of its own, as it is significantly larger than any of the other thrusters and has a few unique features. For one, it needs time to charge up before it can be used, and both while charging and while fully charged, it will passively use power. It can also be extended with more superconductor rings, which doesn't increase the passive power usage, but increases the thrust output and power and propellant usage while boosting linearly. The plasma thruster also warms up over time, while boosting at a minimum of 50% thrust. This warm-up takes 60 seconds at full thrust, and longer the lower the throttle is. While warming up, its thrust output increases linearly, up to an insane 100% increase when fully warmed up. This means that, if long enough, they are by far the most efficient thruster in the game. It also means having a single, longer plasma thruster is a more efficient option than having multiple shorter ones, since multiple plasma thrusters will all have the passive power draw. Plasma thrusters require a lot more pieces than any other thruster. You need 23 parts for a minimum size fully assembled plasma thruster. For this, you need a plasma thruster core, 2 plasma thruster engines, and 2 mirrored plasma thruster engines, 4 plasma thruster frames, 2 nozzle collars, 4 superconductors or superconductor structs, 2 nozzles, the variant without collar in the name, 2 capacitor structs, and 4 plasma thruster capacitors. Thrusters need to be attached to a valid ship frame through a hardpoint. To see what a valid ship frame is, have a look at the beams video I made recently. There I explain how that system works. Thrusters put stress on the frame, and thus you might need to reinforce your ship's frame if you have too many thrusters or too much weight on it. Thrusters have a very long invisible cone behind them, which is very important to keep in mind. If an object is anywhere within that cone, that object will take damage and the thruster will count as partially blocked, and thus make the ship fly in an unstable manner. To prevent this, it's recommended to never put anything behind the thruster at all, even if it is at the other end of your ship. Next to the thrusters themselves, you'll also need something to control them. While you could control their thrust output directly with levers, buttons, or YOLO, it's much easier to use a dedicated flight control system. This flight control system consists of the Flight Control Unit, or FCU, and the main flight computer, or MFC. The FCU handles input from your ship's control levers and tells the MFC which direction to accelerate in. And the MFC then figures out which thrusters to fire and how much. The MFC can be placed anywhere on your ship and just needs to be connected to the ship's cable network. The FCU also needs to be connected to the cable network, but its placement actually matters. There's arrows on it indicating its forward and up directions, and these determine the forward and up direction of your ship. This means it doesn't actually matter in which orientation you built your ship, as long as you put the FCU in the right way. The MFC connects to the thrusters through its thruster state device fields. Every thruster needs to have the same name as one of the device fields in the MFC. You can change the thrusters fields to those in the MFC, but you can also use completely custom names if you want. If two thrusters share the same name, they'll be considered grouped and will always fire at the same percentage of their maximum thrust. Triangles that are connected to each other through their side connection ports are always grouped, and only the thruster that's on the hardpoint needs to be linked to the MFC. Naming triangle thrusters in the same block different names that are both in the MFC is likely to cause strange behavior, so I would highly recommend against doing that. The FCU connects with levers in the same way, by giving their device fields the same name. You don't have to specifically use levers, buttons or YOLO could work here too. However, I'll go over how devices interact with each other in a separate video. Once you have all of your thrusters set up and the rest of the ship built, it could happen that your ship does not behave the way it should. The following are some of the more common issues I've seen pop up, and some likely fixes for them. Firstly, if you notice a certain thruster doesn't fire, make sure to check if it's actually connected to the MFC. If it is, you'll see a long number after it's named the device field. If this number is 0, the thruster isn't properly linked. If this is the case, make sure to double check the name and check for broken cables between the thruster's hardpoint and the MFC. If your ship doesn't fly at all, there could be a few issues. An easy check to perform would be trying to manually turn on a thruster. To do this, rename its thruster state field to something that isn't used anywhere on the ship yet, and set the value to something like 1000. Make sure your mag boots are attached to the ship for this, as it might fly away. If the thruster turns on, that means there is likely a cable broken somewhere in the line between the control levers, FCU, MFC, and thrusters. If the thruster does not turn on, that means there is probably an issue with a cable between your generator or batteries and the thruster, or with a pipe between your propellant tanks and the thruster. It could also be that your generator is turned off and your batteries are empty, or that your propellant tank is closed. You can check this in the respective device's device fields with your U-tool. If the ship is unstable but does fly, or if it flies well in certain directions but some controls are weird, it's likely there are either too few thrusters on the ship to control it appropriately, or the thruster placement might be very unbalanced. It could also be that there is a broken pipe to one of the thrusters. This would be easy enough to check by letting the ship fly forward and looking for thruster trails on all thrusters. Lastly, if some of your controls do work but others do not, there is a good chance there is a connection issue or device field mismatch between the non-functioning controls lever and the FCU. Make sure to check this first before continuing onto the other potential fixes. I hope this video helps you figure out how to set up and troubleshoot your ship's thrusters. Please do leave a like if it did, and maybe even consider subscribing so you'll know when I upload more videos. If you have something in Starbase you want to know more about, feel free to drop a comment below. I'll try to answer them, and if it's a big topic I might make a video on it too. As always, thank you so much for watching. This was Senki, and I'll see you next time.